Hey, Charmed people. Welcome to another day of Charmed. I've been given questions by Adina. She has sent me some very difficult to answer questions, specifically about my favorite, least favorite season, and do I have favorite episode, and, you know, which of the sisters I like best. And some of these things, like the sister thing, I've sort of mentioned on and off over the, you know, maybe not on camera, but certainly in the comments. Sometimes I vibe more with one than another, but I like to see the whole cast, you see, as this big, one big happy family, you know, and picking favorites seems like picking a favorite child, you know. Not that I have any children, but you're not supposed to do it, right? But I've certainly vibed more with some characters over the seasons, and that's kind of changed, like, how I feel about the different sisters and all that. So we'll talk a little bit about it. I won't be able to answer satisfactorily, I don't think. Certainly the episode, like, if I was to pick a favorite episode, I think I'd have to look back at, like, literally, like, what are we up to? We've watched 78 episodes. I'd have to look at the titles and, you know, remember what they're all about and go, oh, that one. And sometimes I'm in a better mood. Like, remember that episode? It's like a silly little episode about this old Western place. And I was in such a good mood that day, just watching that episode. I don't know what it is, a combination of what was happening in my real life or something. I was just in such a good mood watching it. I don't know if that episode was any good or not, but I was in such a good mood watching it that I have a good memory of it, you know? But objectively, like, if I say that's the one I really love, I don't know. I'd have to think about it. I'd have to look at all the episodes. But seasons, we can talk about the seasons in general. I'm trying to think, what would be the weakest season? I'm going to leave season 4 out of it. Season 4 has Prue problems. It's got a Prue hangover in its early episodes, because it has to deal with Prue. And therefore the episodes, a lot of the earlier episodes in this season have to deal with Prue and also have to deal with introducing Paige. So it's very transitional. So it's not fair to judge season 4 along with the other seasons, I don't think. And it's a good season, but it's not... It has to overcome some hurdles, you know, before we can become comfortable. Like, nobody's comfortable at a funeral. Do you know what I mean by that? People are comfortable when they're relaxed, we're getting into a groove or something, we're getting into a little routine, we're getting into a little... We can put our feet up and enjoy an episode. And that's where we're getting to in season 4, I feel. So, that's season 4. Put season 4 aside. Now, as for the other three seasons, I got such... I'm not going to call it nostalgia, because I watched all three seasons, like, pretty much at the same time. But for season 1, so many funny things in season 1. So many things that I latched onto to make jokes about. Like, Buckland's lady, you know, the extras, that guy who appeared near the end of the Buckland's arc that I noticed. Where are you going, dude? He's always going somewhere. So I picked up on a lot of things in season 1 that I still make, you know, still make jokes about, like the pictures on the walls and where is the TV, and I was just having so much fun just goofing them out with season 1, even though I feel like the season 1 episodes weren't that strong overall, you know? I still have really fond memories of, like, I didn't really like the Buckland's building. I didn't really like where Piper was working. Quake? I didn't really like that place, that set. There were very few good scenes there, you know? P3 is better. Although, I'm a bit cynical about when they have actual real-life bands in there. But it's definitely a better set than the Quake was. And Buckland's, nobody did anything in Buckland's. That was the joke, right? Prue is single-handedly keeping that whole building of 100 people afloat. We're just walking around. And I do like when buildings in subsequent seasons remind me of the Buckland's building. You know, they have yellow walls or something. The corridor layout seems similar. So a lot of the things that I am fond about the show started in season one. But I don't think season one is the best season of the three. I'm leaning towards, I don't want you to hold me to this, but I'm leaning towards, certainly leaning towards season three being the strongest of those three. Primarily because I like the Cole arc, the dark Cole arc, before he gets together with Phoebe, or during it, or before we find out that he's evil. The sneaking around and the, you know, questioning his, does he really love Phoebe? All that stuff. Hiding in plain sight, infiltrating them. I really, really enjoyed that arc, because we hadn't really had a proper arc on the show before. Unless you count like boyfriends like Jack or Dan. Speaking of Dan, you know what? I was going to say the Piper Dan Leo stuff. I didn't like that love triangle, because you could kind of only see it going one way, and Dan was such a nice guy. But I kind of miss it too, in a weird way. In a very weird way, I kind of miss it. But yeah, I think that's why I'm leaning towards season three being the strongest. Although I haven't looked through the episodes and I haven't gone, well, hang on a second, all these favorite ones are actually in season two, you know? That might be something for me to look back on at some other time. Just looking at the episodes, you know, individually and going, you know what? These are great. These are terrible. Look, all these good ones in this season, you know? But my feeling is season three. For the dark Cole stuff. And other stuff too. You know, it was when the young Piper got married. And we had some good episodes with Prue as well, before she died. And we had the best Vegas episode, as I like to call them. The episodes where the girls can do whatever they want and nobody needs to bring it up at a later point. We could just forgive it all afterwards. The San Francisco one where they all get a sin each. That was a fun one. Much better than the one where they turn Leo to ice and smash him and just kill him. I didn't like that one. Yeah, so that's the seasons. Episodes, individual episode, which is my favorite episode of those seasons? I don't know. I've got good memories of a lot of them. I love moments in episodes. There's some really strong episodes with Prue. You know, the one at the bridge. And that was the one where Leo got his powers back. Ah, and really funny moments, like Cole appearing at the door and just walking in. Hey, Prue. And she hurls him across the entire manor. It's just the funniest thing, you know? So that's me talking about the show in general. So I would probably, I don't know, three. You know what didn't work in season one, now that I think about season one? The Andy stuff, Andy and Prue. I never felt like they had any real chemistry. I don't think I mentioned it at the time, because I was like, shit, if I say this now and they end up together for eight seasons, I'm going to regret saying it, but there was something about those two that I never really bought that they were in love or had this passion. And we've seen Prue give passionate eyes to people, but I don't think she ever gave them to Andy. And when they were just friends near the end of that season, they worked much better. I was really digging at them. Anyway, as for the sisters, you know, who's my favorite sister? That's a loaded question. Bad question. Don't let me choose. No, I'm not going to choose. It's probably between Piper and Phoebe. It's probably always been between those two, depending on their storylines. When Phoebe was free and single and going on adventures and getting different jobs every other episode and getting herself into all sorts of hijinks and frees a bird and really making me laugh and bringing joy to every episode, and Piper was in the love triangle with Dan and Leo, Phoebe for all of that period, you know, not even a doubt in my mind. Near the start of the show, the start of season one, it was Piper, because I vibed more with her. I felt more in tune with her, because Phoebe's like very extroverted. I am not. In real life, I'm not. And Piper's more sort of down to earth, you know? And now, after the Prue stuff, and since Phoebe's gotten together with Cole, her stories are less... She can't be that free and going on adventures on her own person anymore. And some of those, the aspects of the stuff I liked about her stories are going over to Paige. And now Piper, because of how upset she was when Prue died and I was really vibing with her this season, it's kind of shifting back towards her, you know? It's funny how it's the stories that do it for me, and what how the characters are in those stories and what they have to do and how they make me feel dictates who I like at any given, you know, who I vibe most with. And Paige, that episode with her parents a couple episodes ago, it was probably the first time since she appeared that I was really like, you know what? Yeah. I've liked her since she's appeared, but she made me feel emotional in that episode, and I'm like, yeah, you're, get in here, Paige, you're one of the gang, you know, you're, don't be sad, you know, your parents love you. You know the best thing they've done in this show, randomly now, not have Kit in it. Kit is a bad idea. Kit was a bad idea. Animals are a bad idea. And I presume, canonically, Kit is still around. And I also assume that eventually Kit is going to turn into somebody. Season 9, maybe? Season 10? But having animals in the show? Probably a bad idea. Oh, which kind of worries me about the impending... The foreshadowing of the baby, Piper and Leo having a baby. How does a baby fit into the show? You know, babies usually, I'm not going to say always, but usually detract from a show. Because we have to, a certain portion of every episode needs to be about the baby. We can't just go, hey, let's take off to the forest and go camping and have a spooky adventure with ghosts. It's like, well, who's going to take care of the baby? Let's bring the baby with us, you know? So I'm a little worried about the baby. If there is a baby, we can't have a baby until the source is defeated. So maybe I'm pulling for the source for a little while. Longer? It's a bit like Cole and Phoebe getting together. It takes a little bit away from her storylines and what she can do because she's tied to somebody. Remember I was saying never tie Phoebe to a guy? Never tie Phoebe to a job. Because everything that worked for Phoebe and why I was her, she was my favorite character in the earlier seasons, was because she was so She didn't have to go to Quake every day. She didn't have to go to Bucklands every day. She was the fun of Charmed, you know? And she's still fun. But she's a little bit tied to Cole now. A little bit tied. Their stories are sort of intermingled now. So she has less room to do things. Paige, however, currently can do all that stuff if they want to write an episode about that. So at least they have somebody they can have the kind of more free, fun aspects with. So, which season did I like the best? Season 3, currently. Although my favourite episode may not be in that season. Prue and Andy never worked for me. Daryl, Team Daryl all the way. Daryl. The great thing about Daryl is they use him so sparingly that every time he appears, I'm like, yeah, buddy. If he was in it every episode, I'd be like, oh, geez. Do we have to have Daryl in every episode? Paige is rising. Piper is probably my favorite at the moment, maybe. You know? I've grown to really like her exasperation and what she does with her hands when she's frustrated. I've said that best Piper is the frustrated Piper. And best Phoebe is free Phoebe. Best Prue is when she's flirting with somebody. And she didn't get to do that many times. But when she was really feeling it, you know, when she was giving people the eyes. Hey, she even, I'm telling you, she had a moment with Cole in that episode I was telling you about, where they team up and go to that Western. And he's standing over her, and there's just this just for a moment, there's electrical spark. You know, it's sort of a hate relationship, but it was for a little moment, there was at least in my brain. I wish we'd seen more of that from Prue. I wish they'd given her I wish she was less the older sister, you know, taking care of business, being the serious one. And we should have seen more of her photography. She got that hobby and then she kind of dropped it. But the best thing they've dropped in season 4 and maybe the end of season 3, the Sparkle people. We haven't seen them in a very long time. Because they went through a little phase where they were pissing me off, and every decision they were making, they were worse than the source. They were worse than down there. So they cooled off on that whole thing. They stopped mentioning them. Leo mentions them all the time, but they are not part of the episodes. They could come back into it. I know. Anyway, did I answer anything? Maybe a little bit. Nothing definitive though. The sisters are always very close. Even though Prue was never my number one sister, like, I don't think there was ever a point where I'm like, she's my favorite sister because of this episode right now. She was always very close to them. She was never a distant third. You know, they're all very close together, and they work because of each other. You can't take one out like Prue. It's hard to you know, separate them. And Paige has had work to do to feel like she's in the three and not just 2 plus 1, you know? So, oh, and I'll say it now. I didn't say it in season 1 about not liking Bucklands. I don't like where Paige is working. I don't like that place. Is it because it's kind of an officey job and I just don't, that sort of thing I don't really like, you know, in general. I have no good memories of office work or the nonsense that goes on there, and her boss is just I don't like him, and Well, I mean, there's nothing to not like about him. He's just a boss, but I'd be happy if she changed professions or went the Phoebe route and just discovered her art, went for a wander, you know, like, remember Cole going for his wander and we never talk about it again? Anyway, Cole and Phoebe are going to get married. Piper and Leo are going to have a baby. It's all going to happen in this episode. This episode's called, what is it called? Charmed and Dangerous. So we'll get into that now. I'll talk to YouTube. We'll get into it. What happened last time? Lost and Bound. That kid. Right. Right. Good timing. Good timing. I can pause until the dog stops and then say hello to YouTube. Wow, I talked for 20 minutes. I talked for 20 minutes and said nothing. So yeah, on the seasons thing, I think rather than liking seasons, I like arcs or eras and dislike other eras. Like disliking the Dan Leo triangle. Although, I'm kind of nostalgic about it. And liking the Cole Phoebe getting the start of that, getting together. I don't like that he lost his powers. I want him to get his back. I want him to get his bike back. And I don't mean just beating up on people like he was doing last episode. Okay, let's go. Hey, everybody. It's episode 13. But is it Friday the 13th? I don't think so. It is Charmed and Dangerous. This aired on the 7th of February, 2002. A week before Valentine's Day, next episode's called The Three Faces of Phoebe. Oh, geez. What? I kind of want to watch that one. Anyway, Charmed and Dangerous. Last time, we had a little boy who was a fire starter. And he burned the whole manor down. But it's okay. We just got the guy who fixes the clock to fix up the whole manor. So you won't even notice it. Won't even notice it. And if you were to put a gun to my head now and ask me what happened to that kid in the last episode. The foster system? I don't really remember. Where did he come from? Who gave birth to him? I don't really remember. All I know is that demons, bounty hunters, wanted to hand him over to the source. And they didn't. Also, Phoebe went on a little bit of a bewitched adventure, and then she threw away her grandmother's ring. She doesn't like heirlooms. They should have uncursed it, or re-spelled it, or bewitched it in a different way, to make all their dreams come true. So you can't cast spells for personal gain, but you can certainly curse yourself, apparently. Can't you build up a bit of karma? You know, curse yourself a little bit and then do a bit of personal gain to balance it out? How about that? Oh, one of these starts. What the hell happened? The source!
Seems almost anticlimactic.
Is this a dream? Is this a...
Say hello to Prue
vision?
For me.
The P word!
Now!
Whoop.
Crystal Circle!
Are we killing the source? Right now? Ooh, vision! Who's having this vision? You're not Crystal Ball, lady.
Well, what did you see?
They kill you.
I saw...
your death.
Your demise.
That cannot be.
He's got a different voice.
The Charmed One's power must simply be greater than yours.
They got plot armor.
Then the only way to change what you see is to obtain more power. The ultimate power.
What?
That's forbidden. The Hollow has been banished for all eternity. We all could die.
With the Hollow, I will render the witches powerless, even if it means destroying us all.
Oh, he's gone rogue. We gotta take out the source. The demons, get the demons together. Hey, whoever's voicing him? They changed the guy voicing him. I kind of recognize the voice, actually. By the way, can we talk about how much the theme tune is absolutely fantastic? 79 episodes in, I'm still rocking out to it. Yeah! We might have lost guy getting hit by a car, but we have a Daryl episode.
Do I really need to think about this now?
Yes, because the source has already killed one of us.
Is this a will?
You should be honored that if we don't make it, we're leaving you everything.
He gets the house.
Guess what?
What makes you think I'm going to outlive you anyway?
You're an angel, literally.
Source bulletin, this just in.
We nailed the source vanquishing spell.
Oh, nice.
If we could draw the magic from the entire Halliwell line,
we might have enough power to vanquish the source.
This might work.
I'll go tell the others.
The who?
Did not sign this.
Oh, honey, are you still on that last will and testament?
No one is gonna die anytime soon.
Oh, look at this face. Is that what the source looks like? Cole!
You right?
Yeah.
He took a blast for you.
I just have the hiccups. Piper, can I talk to you for a minute in the kitchen?
Sure.
Hey, Piper, could you freeze everybody for a second?
I just saw him jump in front of a demon to take a fireball for me.
A demon?
He does that sort of thing.
One with a half a face. Well, can't you talk to him? He's not going to sit by the sidelines. It's not who he is.
Yeah.
So you're not going to tell him. The attack happened in the attic. So I'll just keep him out of the house.
The judge just wants to hear the truth. That's all.
What's this about? Who are you?
Yeah, but once he hears about all the awful things I've done.
We're not going to pretend that you weren't in an abusive relationship or that you didn't go to rehab.
But you've changed. That's all that matters.
The judge just cares about who you are. Not about who you were.
Well, sometimes.
It's gonna help you get your son back. It's not a good time. I'm in the middle of something important.
Phoebe had a premonition and not a good one.
I know why I'm whispering. Why are you?
No, it keeps making this like,
Look, if you could just take it to the mechanic and have him look at it, that would be great.
A day thing or a night thing?
Night.
What thing?
Surprise party. Okay. Get out of here.
There's nothing wrong with Piper's car, is there?
No.
But you want me to leave, don't you?
Yes.
You'll tell me later?
I promise.
Come back at dawn.
All right.
Perfect. You didn't suspect a thing.
I love that man. You need to come home now.
They all have tattoos all of a sudden.
I promised her I'd be at the hearing today.
Okay, fine. But you need to come home as soon as you can.
God, I don't know what I'd do without you. You're my angel.
Aww. Oh. speaking of angels, hello.
Make a damned move.
What the shit is this? Oh, nice.
There.
Hey, Source. We're just playing chess.
This place is an ancient burial ground.
Oh, do you think good and evil are standing guard together? Because it's forbidden for anybody to come here and take the power of the Deathly Hallows? Or something? It was something like that. It's not a Harry Potter thing, but it's close to it. I was wondering why good and evil were kind of hanging out together. But it makes sense if this place is so important that... But then if it was so important, you'd have more people protecting it. But yeah, it makes sense. Anyway, that's it. I like getting rid of Cole, you know? He knows something's up. And if he knows something's up, he's going to be hanging around, and there's better ways to get rid of him. Tell him to go and walk about again. That might work.
You're not allowed to be here.
Have you forgotten who I am?
Your voice keeps changing. She's no good at protecting anything. She just got eviscerated. Nice. Nice hit. You're next, dude.
Please. The Hollow is a threat to us all. Its power is too great.
That's exactly the kind of power I need.
It's gonna burn you. Well, at least that guy did try to stop him. Halo girl didn't do anything. Oh crap, he's opening the door. Ooh, it's a box. Can you believe this other guy's still alive?
No! The Hollow consumes power!
Good thing he didn't open it the other way.
Now you will be able to consume powers and give them to me.
Hey, dude.
Viper!
Oh, the mirror. I was wondering why there was a mirror there.
Viper, blow him up!
Uh-oh. Mike. Oh, Phoebe! Freaking Phoebe! She okay? That's the second time she's almost died in the last few episodes.
She almost died, that's what's taking so long.
Leo saved three people in like three episodes.
And did you get him?
Yes.
Sort of.
But something else got away.
Mosquitoes or something.
Throw this.
Oh, she lost her powers.
My powers are gone.
That thing must have absorbed her power somehow, though I don't know how.
That's him. This is him.
Nice picture again.
Of the Hollow? Ring any bells?
Oh, that's not possible. The Hollow is something that consumes all magic, good or evil, and both sides agree to guard it.
There's no mention of a vanquish here.
You can't vanquish it. The last time it was unleashed, it nearly decimated all magic. Good and evil had to join forces, and even then, all they could do was contain it.
In a box.
Okay, you better get Paige. You're gonna need the power of three. I'll go check with the elders.
Good thinking. Who are you going to see?
She wouldn't sabotage this, not when she's come so close to getting her son back. God, I hope her ex didn't find her. Oh, hey, Phoebe. Look, I'm gonna need more time.
This part of the episode doesn't seem so important anymore.
What do you need me to do?
I need you to postpone the hearing for a couple hours.
I'll try.
Thanks. Just keep paging her, trying her at home. We have got to find her.
Hi.
Oh, hey.
We need his help. No time to be evasive.
Look, it's obvious you're making a potion, so what is it you're not telling me?
We didn't see him die. We did see him take a blast.
A demon attacked and you jumped in front of a fireball to save me.
What? What'd he look like?
A creepy half-face. Do you know who he is? Does he work for the source?
He
doesn't work for the source, Phoebe. He is the source.
So he's the one that released the Hollow. It took Piper's power.
Well, then you better figure out a way to beat the source without your powers, otherwise...
Yeah, we got a potion.
Already on it.
He's got Piper's both at the same time.
His powers are impressive.
That's cool.
Do you think...
We've never seen Piper do that at the same time. Freeze and also break apart. See the way they were just, they're showing off. They're like, hey, look what we can do. Visually. That's pretty cool. And good demonstration of his mastery of the power. This woman, I want Orb Woman back. I know she's dead. This one isn't touching herself or doing anything weird. She's just being sage. What kind of a stupid oracle are you? Just giving advice. Ah, no. You gotta be weird.
There could be repercussions.
I won't stop until I have all three of their powers coursing through my veins.
Ask what she sees now.
No one wins while the Hollow roams free.
I control the Hollow.
Do you though?
For now.
Hey.
I want the charmed ones, Darklighter.
But my arrows don't kill witches.
But they do kill Whitelighters. I want you to kill theirs, so he can't heal them anymore.
Yeah, he's been working overtime. Hey, I almost forgot to mention this. I've been so caught up in the episode. This is a high-stakes episode. The source is front and center. Piper's lost her powers. We got visions of cold thrown himself in front of a fireball. Now Leo's on the next to be shot list. And hey, we know how important Leo's been over the last few episodes. Both Phoebe and Cole would be dead right now if Leo wasn't around. So, yeah, pretty high stakes for an episode 13, isn't it?
5 magic crystals oriented east to west.
Oh, we've seen this.
Magic circle check.
East to west, remember?
One fabulously written source vanquishing spell.
Good and evil magic need to join forces and read the inscription on the box where the hollow is kept.
Hey, Cole, too bad you're not still evil.
Maybe he can, this is how he gets these powers back. He has to sacrifice himself to become evil and sit over the box.
Yeah, the ER doctor said there was no internal bleeding, but she still got beat up pretty
freaking
bad.
Freaking out!
How did he find her?
Well, I've got every available officer out there looking for him.
She should be in the hospital.
With her history, this doesn't look good.
We need you in the kitchen.
You know, Leo, I have my charges too.
Oh, Leo! Duck! We can't kill Leo. Frickin' mosquitoes. Can we save him? Isn't this like poison tipped or something? We pulled it through all the way through.
Paige, don't touch that. You're a white lighter too.
Oh yeah, can she... Could Paige heal a little bit? Hang in there.
He knows what we're gonna do before we even do.
Well, it's not over yet. I still have my power.
What can Phoebe do? She can see him coming. She can fly.
What is it?
Oh, her. She can close the box. She could be the evil person who helps us at the end. I was like, who are we going to get that's evil? She seems very... she doesn't like this whole box hollow idea. So...
What do you see?
Nothing.
Nothing?
What do you mean?
Are we all dead?
I see nothing.
The end of all life in the universe?
No magic. No life. No world.
Then if there's no future, I have no further need for you, do I, Seer?
Dude.
Find another way.
Not until I've killed them all.
He's obsessed.
The Hollow won't let you stop there.
And so be it!
He's already too far gone. We need a coup.
One more power to obtain.
You gotta do something, lady.
Hey.
They don't start the episode willing the house to Leo and then have Leo die. No. They have to have a baby.
Guess you picked the wrong beneficiary after all.
Don't talk like that. You're not gonna die. Because I'm not gonna let you.
If Leo dies, Piper will destroy the whole world, even if she doesn't have any powers. What you doing, Cole?
What's that?
This. It's just a little something I've been waiting for the right moment to give you.
A ring? Now? Ooh. Is it cursed?
It's not your grams, but hopefully it's not cursed.
He wants to do it before he might not have a chance to.
This way, no matter what happens, you'll always know that I love you.
I'll be right there.
I called Daryl.
Daryl, you're supposed to be helping Phoebe.
She doesn't need my help, but there is somebody who does. Excuse me.
Yeah, B plot, Piper.
I'm so sorry, Paige.
It's not over.
We don't have time for other people's problems right now.
It's something I've got to do, especially if it's the last thing I do.
I can respect that.
The judge will take one look at me.
No, I think I can help.
How do our powers help with this? Oh, spell. Okay.
You're gonna use magic?
Yeah.
Yes, I am. Let the object of objection become but a dream as I cause the scene to be unseen.
All the scars disappear?
And make sure that slime bag ex of hers gets put away.
At least Darryl's gonna survive the episode. Everybody in the house? Is in danger, so...
We may have a plan to get your powers back.
Then maybe Paige could help heal Leo. Remember the one to call for witch's powers? It might be strong enough to call the powers from the Hollow.
Ooh. Yeah, these do. What the hell? Just you just got summoned by the Oracle lady, right?
Don't be afraid.
What's the deal, lady?
Sir.
Even now I can see the void where your demon half used to exist.
Can you give me my powers back?
I had a vision. One where you and I do great things together.
Ooh.
If you hope to save your precious witch, only you and I can help her defeat the source.
I'm listening.
He's in.
If you take in the hollow, you can absorb the source's power when he attacks.
Oh. This seems dangerous, doesn't it?
What happens to me after?
We put you in the box.
The witches and I will banish the hollow back to its crypt. You'll return to normal.
Oh, do you trust her?
How do I know this isn't just one of the source's tricks? Or one of yours, for that matter?
I don't trust her. I trust the plan. But I don't trust that Cole will be okay. I'm having a vision of Cole getting sucked into a box. And Phoebe, all that she has left of him is the ring. Now, can we get Cole back if the story goes that way? Of course we can. But all this, you'll return to normal stuff? I'm nervous about that. He's always going to do something to help Phoebe. I thought it was going to go away like Leo, you know? Get your powers back, you save the person you want to save. So he would go evil again to save Phoebe. That's a good story. But this seems a bit... If it's the way she says it, okay. But I'm just nervous about it. Especially given the ring situation. Yeah, so that's... I'm nervous. I'm hopeful. And I'm nervous. Did I say that already?
And if I do this, what do you say then?
A future for both sides.
Do you see me getting married to Phoebe? Do you see the pitter-patter of tiny feet? Tell me more. I don't want to live in a box.
Is this the great thing you saw us doing together?
Perhaps.
She's tricksy. I don't trust her. Maybe he'll just stay evil.
It's your only chance to save your love.
Let's do it.
Rise,
course,
and see across the skies. Come to us and call your
near.
Come to us and settle here.
Oh, it's the fastest they've ever set a spell.
Oh,
there he is.
Oh my god. Shall we call for
power? I have your powers now.
Oh, it's the fireball. She's just a bit dazed. Get upstairs.
Hurry, he's coming.
Yeah, that's what we saw at the start.
Almost anticlimactic.
Get out of here, dude. They got a mattress up here.
Say hello to Prue for me.
Hey! Yeah, you can't steal that power. Nice trick. Get trapped.
Crystal.
What? That's cheating.
Now the moment we've all been waiting for.
Oh.
Belphasaur!
No, the hollow.
Hurry, the spell!
Prudence, Patricia, Penelope.
Vanquish is evil for time and space!
We're done! Source is done. Finally. Now, what happens to Cole? The box! Everything goes back to normal, right?
Quickly, take my hand.
Trust her.
Okay.
If you want your powers back.
She's shady, but everything's happened the way she said it was gonna.
Say the inscription with me. Abolio ex tum cavi.
Who gets to guard it, though? Real good? Everything's just been so... Everything's so neat and tidy. Yeah, heal the sweater too.
All is as it should be.
You still here?
Time to return to my side.
Get out of here.
Too bad Belphasaur's gone. He would have made a great new source.
Too bad.
Does he still have the cool fireball power?
We thank you.
Oh, I didn't do this for your future. I did it for mine.
Yeah, she saw something.
If we got our powers back, where did the sources go?
Into the void.
See you later.
Who was that?
A very evil person.
Keep an eye on her.
Yeah, I still can't believe it. You guys actually vanquished the source.
Now we can have a child.
For Prue.
Oh, Prue.
For Prue.
What do you say we go home and get started on our future?
Hi, Henry. Are you okay?
Yeah, why?
Well, it just took you a while to get back.
You feeling okay?
Yeah, I'm just a little, tired.
He's just tired.
And you're also my hero.
Oh, I'm nobody's hero.
Happy ending. You gotta, he's keeping some of it. Or all of it. He's got some demon in him, again. Just what was missing from his life. And he's not in the box. He's not in the box. I think I've been watching too many Night Gallery / Twilight Zone / Outer Limits episodes. I was like, he's going to end up in the box. It's a trick. He's making a pact and he doesn't know the deal. Don't sign the contract till you read all the fine print. Or I thought, he's going to be the guy guarding the box for eternity. Or at the end, when Phoebe was standing next to the woman, I was like, oh, maybe she's going to be the new Halo person. We don't need a new Halo person or a new demon to guard the box, because let's face it, they were there for what, hundreds of years? They barely put up a fight. Now, was it the most powerful demon coming for them? Sure, but here's how I would have changed that little part of that episode. The chess game between good and evil, a classic. I love it. Okay? But what you do is, you can still have those two at the door, you know, having their chess game, but in front of the door and like down a huge long chamber, there's like 12, 24 demons and angels, all, you know, all very well defined, you know, wearing dark and light colors, and the source has to come in and, you know, really, really fight his way. He's taking on some gargoyles as well, you know. Take that, you stupid gargoyle. Hey, they should have one of those for their attic anyway. And he fights his way to the Halo and demon chess people, and they're super powerful, and it takes everything in his last strength to overcome both of them, and then he can finally open the door and get the box. Really make him work for it. Really make it, this box, seem like it's the most protected thing in the entire universe. So that, holy shit, he finally got the forbidden box. That's, you know, no normal person could ever have fought their way through to get this box and get the source of ultimate evil that can destroy both demon and angel kind forever. You know? Now, do we need a little bit of extra budget to make that my vision a reality? Yes. But that's how I would have changed that. Instead, it was just those two. She went down here, get fireballed. He survived. He survived. And he got, you know, he got mosquitoed. The charmed one got him. But this is the end of the source arc. And it was just a guy in the end. Just the most powerful demon. I liked it. A little bit jarring at the start because his voice was much different to how it had always been. It had been much deeper than in this episode, but the reason they changed it is because they needed the actor to be both visible and speaking. you know. So they had to go with that actor's voice. And he was lost. He was crazy. He was completely invested in his plan for, not revenge, but for power. And the Charmed Ones had given him such pain over the years that he was willing to sacrifice the entire universe just to get them, you know? Whereas she was very calm. She's more of a threat because she's very calm and careful. And she even appeased the source when he started, "Hey, do I need to kill you?" She's like, "Hey, I'm your loyal servant. I will guard the box." And happy ending. Cole has, we don't know, but he has demon eyes. Some of the source's power, some of the Hollow's power has gone into him. He has something. He seems to have lost his human sparkle at the end. He was a bit distant. Is that going to affect the wedding? Perhaps. Is he going to be far more interesting now than he was as a human? Yeah, a little bit. I wanted him to get some powers back. Because I really like Dark Cole. So we'll see what they do with it. We'll see how temporary this is. And what plans she has for him. And if she is actually going to be in another episode. And if they are going to be working together for something else. Who's the source now? Who's the head honcho now? Is it her? Is somebody else going to move in on the territory? Good episode. Felt very end of season-y. We'll call it a mid-season finale. High stakes. Leo was dying. Piper was dying. People had lost their powers. Phoebe almost died. The only person who didn't almost die was Paige. Paige had a whole other story going on. Then let's face it, nobody really cared about that poor woman though. Did you see what happened to her? It didn't tie into anything. And Daryl was just sort of there, you know, helping out. It showed us that even in this, the face of massive peril, Paige still wants to help the helpless. Even when her own powers are on the line and bigger things are happening and the world is ending, she's still looking out for people. So good character growth for her. Also shows us that she's still doing her own thing. She's still a little bit separate from the other two. Just a little bit. She has her independence. And so she should. She's not tied down to anybody. You know? We may not see Glenn again. She's flirting with this bar guy. Oh, and the episode started. As some episodes do. Right in the middle of the action. Although in this case it was a vision. Do I miss Orb Lady? Of course I do. She was hilarious. This new one is sinister. The old one was hilarious. So I'll take sinister over hilarious, but begrudgingly. Right, that was it. Next episode is the funniest title in the world. It's called The Three Faces of Phoebe. So, remember when Prue split in three? I wonder what this is going to be about. We're going to have to deal with Cole. The subtle changes in Cole, maybe. But how that becomes a Phoebe episode, I'm not sure. We're going to continue the Leo and Piper talk about having a child. They might be having it right now, right this second. Not sure. But. Next week's episode aired on the 14th of February, which, as we all know, is Valentine's Day. Very romantic episode ahead for us. At least one of these faces of Phoebe we'll be having a great romantic time. So come back for that next time. Thank you for joining me for this time. See you later.